Hey, it's Ed here. Welcome back to our series on startups. And we've been following the journey of My Benefits AI. And this time, our guest, returning guest, is the CEO, Priyam. Priyam, welcome back to Startups, My Benefits AI.
Thank you, Ed. Good morning.
Hey, it's great to have you back. It's been a couple of months. We've had some, the engineer, head of engineering on, we've had customers on, other advisors. And so it's been a few weeks, so we just want to catch up a little bit. Can you give everyone just a thumbnail on My Benefits AI in case they missed the first couple episodes, and then we'll jump into what's been going on.
Sure. MyBenefits.ai was developed in bridging the gap between healthcare providers and patient hospital to home care. It was a journey started because of my dad, who was diagnosed with colorectal cancer. We got home and we had so many questions, so many things that we didn't know, and that's how we started this product. We wanted to support patients at home, helping the providers to reduce their workload.
Yeah, it's brilliant because that is an area where there hasn't been a lot of focus and attention, and it really needs to have that be for many reasons, especially patient experience, but also clinician experience, and it also has impact on the revenue cycle as well. So there's all sorts of positive reasons to really close that gap, and MyBenefits.ai really addresses that. Now, the last time, just for our list watchers, the last time we were talking, you were about to embark on a trip to India, and I think you've gone back a couple times. And tell us a little bit about what's going on in India and why you've been making those trips.
So Ed, we have made significant progress since we last talked. Our technology is fully baked in at this time. Our AI-powered health clinician is much more advanced in various types of care, in gastroenterology, ENT, urology, breast cancer. And with my trips to India, we're really focused on onboarding hospitals in India. Since then, we have onboarded four hospitals in different types of care types, some multi-specialty. We are seeing patients onboarding and supporting patients. We have almost now over hundreds of patients on our platform, including cancer patients, and we are seeing our platform used and really benefiting the providers and the patient at this time.
Yeah, the other, now that's super exciting, because again, if people have been following along with us, or if they go back, we started basically with no clients. We had a pilot, and now you've got these clients and a lot of action happening in the United States as well, just on the, they'll have to wait to the next edition of this startup series to catch up on that. Tell us a little bit about the software though, because the last time we spoke, we also were, early in the software, but obviously you've had multiple iterations since then. What's the latest and what's still to come?
What we have implemented is what we call a safety model, and we are actually, what is a safety model? Whenever you build up an AI platform, especially in healthcare, you need to reduce the hallucination that happens by providing, the correct set of information to the patients, and also reducing, any noise that comes out with the data that comes out from the large language models. So we have created our proprietary modeling languages, models to help the patients really focus on their personal needs, and by understanding their personal patients' history, their patient, the care type that they went for, the surgical notes. And so we have really created the data layers of personalization, built-in algorithms, and we also did what we call is a continuous learning model from clinicians and patients to drive the better outcomes for the patients, as well as provide a better information back to the providers. So what we have implemented a very smart safety model features that will help reduce the noise that are happening in the AI space in healthcare.
Yeah, no, that's super exciting about where this is all heading. And again, you've had this great success to date. It is super exciting. Hey, if someone wants more information, because I think now, I mean, even before when we started the series, it was ready, but for sure now, how do people get more information about MyBenefits.ai?
So this is a great thing, Ed. We are looking at partners. What we are looking at, hey, we want to onboard hospitals in the United States, across the world, including India. We have live patients on our platform. So we are looking for partners to come in and join us. We are showing the value from, you know, the patient side of it, from the provider side of it, how many calls we have reduced, how many readmissions that we have reduced or provided benefit for on the patient side. And we are looking for partners. And we would show the value before even we embark the journey of, you know, the sales.
Yeah, well, that's cool. So yeah, if anyone's out there watching and you're on the provider side, and you want to do innovation and transformation and be part of something pretty significant, reach out. So I'll put your information in the show notes so people will know how to reach you. Priyam, thank you so much for the update. I'm so excited for you and the team. So much progress since we last spoke, and I look for continued progress the next time we check in with you.
Thank you, Ed. Thank you so much.
All right. That wraps up our lessons or journey along the startup continuum. Thanks for watching.